Hey guys, this is Marcel Ernie with Ernie Racing News reporting July 3rd. Just ended Canada's long weekend here Sunday. I'm catching up on the weekend news, and that is Christine Anderson, the member of the European Parliament for Germany. She is the Alternative for Germany, AfD, and she actually made a video, interviewed herself about wanting to come to Canada to be here for Canada Day. And of course, she was not allowed in the country for her choice for medical autonomy and, of course, for her political views or views on not going along with totalitarianism, not going along with dictator Trudeau. So, if no further ado, Christine Anderson.
Hello, Canada. Hello, freedom truckers. And hello to all of those fighting for freedom, democracy, and the rule of law. I was supposed to be in Ottawa today. I was supposed to be right there with you, celebrating your country's exceptional history, culture, and achievements, which you have every reason to be so very proud of. It was a great honor to have been asked to join you today, and I would have loved to be there amongst you, people who I consider the most courageous and bravest people of our time. But I was not allowed to enter your beautiful country because I chose to exercise one of the most fundamental rights of all. I chose to decide what happens with my body. I refused to be injected with an experimental drug. Now, while your prime minister embraces the concept of my body, my choice, this apparently only applies when it is about killing unborn babies. After Roe versus Wade has been overturned, your prime minister invited women of the US to come to Canada to have an abortion. Mr. Trudeau, I'm asking you, does this invitation also apply to unvaccinated women? Unfortunately, your once free country, however, has fallen victim to an unscrupulous globalist elite who installed a well-trained puppet to harass, criminalize, and terrorize anyone who will not comply with the agenda of the globalists. And then you, the Canadian truckers, came along and simply said, no, we will not comply. And then something happened that is nothing short of a miracle. You organized the protest, which is possibly the biggest protest of our times that we have seen in a long time. The headlights of your trucks became the light of hope, which worked its way all throughout the world, touching millions and millions of people, inspiring them to stand up and speak out against their governments. The globalist elites attempt to install tyrannical regimes in every single country, you were the one saying, not here and not with us. And even though you, the Canadian freedom truckers, are subject to political persecution and are labeled terrorists, the day will come when your bravery and your determination to fight for freedom will be recognized and you will be granted your rightful place in the history books. To future generations, the Canadian Freedom Trucker Movement will be known as one of the most significant resistance movements of our time, who took upon them enormous personal sacrifices to defend and to restore freedom, democracy, and the rule of law for all of us. One of these days, I will come to Canada and I will get to meet my favorite heroic freedom fighters. So please, I thank you. Keep up the fight. God bless you. And I'm convinced in the end, we, the people, will prevail.
Ooh, wow. That was an amazing speech, Christine Anderson. Wow, it'd sure be awesome to meet her one day. Hopefully she gets to Canada. Hopefully I can get to Germany. Go hang out with BMW and go hang out with my Austrian friends at KTM. And Schubert in Germany. Hello, Schubert, if you're watching. Anyways, guys, Christine Anderson, MEP for the AfD, German member of the EU Parliament. One of three that actually called out Trudeau when Trudeau visited the European Parliament, if you guys saw that. I guess I'll have to find the old footage from that a month ago where they called him out and, what are you doing here? You're a dictator. We don't want to hear you. Please spare us your presence, Trudeau.
Based on Article 195, out that it would have been more appropriate for Mr. Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada, to address this House according to Article 144, an article which was specifically designed to debate violations of human rights, democracy, and the rule of law, which is clearly the case with Mr. Trudeau. Then again, a Prime Minister who openly admires the Chinese basic dictatorship, who tramples on fundamental rights by persecuting and criminalizing his own citizens as terrorists just because they dared to stand up to his perverted concept of democracy, should not be allowed to speak in this House at all. Mr. Trudeau, you are a disgrace for any democracy. Please spare us your presence. Thank you. Mr. Trudeau, you are a disgrace for any democracy. Please spare us your presence. Thank you.
Yeah, Christina Anderson headed out of the park at the EU Parliament. So next, we're going to go on to another member of Parliament. Let me just pull up his name. Mislav Kolaskov. He's born in 1969. He's a Croatian lawyer and politician and member of the European Parliament for Croatia since 2019. Previously, he served as a judge at the Zagreb Commercial Court. So without further ado, let's take a listen.
Poštovane kolege, dragi građani, premijeru Trudeau. Sloboda, pravo izbora, pravo na život i zdravlje, pravo na rad za mnoge od nas, to su temeljna ljudska prava za koje su milioni građana Europe i svijeta položili svoje živote. Za obranu naših prava i prava naše djece, koje smo stjecali stoljećima, mnogi od nas, uključujući i mene, spremni smo riskirati vlastitu slobodu i položiti vlastite živote. Nažalost, danas su među nama i oni koji gaze te temeljne vrijednosti. Kanada, nekada simbol modernog svijeta, je pod vodstvom vaše kvaziliberalne čizme proteklih mjeseci postala simbol kršenja temeljnih ljudskih prava i građanskih sloboda. Gledali smo kako konjima gaze žene, kako samohranim roditeljima blokirate bankovne račune, da ne mogu platiti djeci školovanje, da ne mogu platiti lijekove, da ne mogu platiti račune za struju i vodu, da ne mogu platiti rate kredita za svoje domove. Za vas su to možda liberalne metode. Međutim, za mnoge građane svijeta to je diktatura najgore vrste. Budite uvjereni da građani svijeta, udruženi, mogu zaustaviti svaki režim koji želi uništiti slobodu građana, bilo bombama, bilo štetnim farmaceutskim proizvodima. Hvala.
Wow, that was awesome. Hit a very, hit some quality points there. Freezing the bank accounts, the police trampling on its citizens. Oh, yeah, unbelievable. Okay, let's go on. There's one more member of parliament. Bernard Zimnoil, sorry, I don't know how to pronounce these names. Bernard Zimnoik, born 1953, is a German politician and former Bundeswehr colonel who is serving as an alternative for Germany member of the European Parliament. Zimnoik served in the German army for 15 years as part of the Airborne Division and attained the rank of lieutenant colonel. Okay, without further ado, let's listen to this German nationalist.
President, honourable members, we keep discussing here our European democratic values that underpin all of our actions. I worked in Syria and Pakistan for many years as a diplomat and therefore value democracy very highly. Now, the invitation to Canadian PM Justin Trudeau is an invitation to someone who's been trampling on democratic rights, who's been cracking down on people who protested against disproportionate corona measures. People's who were supporting a non-sanctioned movement coming under criticism. So clearly the values of democracy are being despised by this individual. Let us not give someone like this any speaking time in this house of democracy.
Okay. That again, Bernard Zimnoik. Great stuff. I'm going to leave it at that, guys. This is Marcel Ernie, Ernie Racing News. Just kind of getting back in the swing of things. Peace.